Why, hello there. Looking for Greek light cavalry from the Greek or Persian Wars, or any of the Greek Wars, to be honest. You came to the right place. This is Imperator Vespasian and his trusty sidekick.
Hello.
And we're doing a very simple unboxing on these figures. There's not a huge amount of to do with unboxings with these guys, because cavalry is cavalry, and there's not a huge amount of options with them. They're the finished figures, but these are the cavalry. And they're the same as the Persians, more or less. They're just two-piece figures you stick together. They've got the nice leopard skin. Leopard?
I'm not getting this debate.
Not getting this debate. And some cloth covers, which is probably more likely for the Greeks to have. Greek light cavalry tended to not really take a huge amount of part in a battle.
I take it these ones were definitely used as skirmishers.
Yeah, they were often sent ahead
of an army,
to try and head off troops and stuff, and that would force the retreating enemy to form a screen, so at least some of the enemy might get caught, but they weren't...
A fraction,
a small amount. There was a instance where cavalry did actually defeat a Spartan unit that was chasing them. And there was another one where the Spartan light infantry outran the Greek cavalry.
How?
They were Spartans.
That's true.
they didn't care.
They killed wolves in the winter, half naked.
They actually outran the Theban cavalry and got to the fort before the Theban cavalry did. Although there weren't enough Spartans to actually block the Theban army from marching through. But it was the fact they made it before them is kind of embarrassing. So, yeah, Greek cavalry, slower than Spartans. But, you know.
That's the end of the video then. It's just useless stuff.
Yeah. I think that was actually in the Greco-Persian War when they were fighting the Thebans. I know later on the Spartans ditched armour for like one battle. And because of that, you can now buy unarmored Spartans for some reason. And yet it was only one battle that ever happened in. But who cares? Silliness abides. So here we have the fourth horse here. And that is exactly the same as the Persian horse of the same range. And the unarmored cavalry. The main difference between these and the Persians is these have got bare legs and the Persians wear trousers. Persians are slightly more civilised. Long-haired trouser wearers.
Well, what are we talking about? We're talking about Athenians, or we're talking about Thebans, and we're talking about Spartans. There's no real debate. They're all uncivilised.
They're all a bit dodgy, if you want my opinion. Which is the one that hangs dead bodies from trees?
That's Spartans, isn't it?
No. Their culture is to hang that when someone passes away. Normally, under normal circumstance, they hang them from a tree.
I don't think it's Athenians. I don't think it's Athenians.
Plataeans.
Right.
Yeah. When the Persians invaded Plataea, they were terrified because there were bodies hanging from the trees and they didn't realise that this was just a local custom. They thought these Plataeans had found people and hung them. They thought these guys were lunatics. But it was just a way of giving back to nature. There's one of the Persian groups, they had flat roofs on their houses, and they used to put dead bodies on the roof for the birds to eat so it would rot away in the sun.
Oh, how lovely.
Then they'd descend it with skeleton bones, and then they'd put them in a pot and bury them.
Fantastic.
Yes. Persians are weird too.
Why not cremation?
The Greeks went in for cremation a bit, not a huge amount. I think it had to be really important.
Or just bury the guy.
Wood's expensive, you know. they did. They did bury people. That's how come we have bodies. Then we have the weapons for them, and it's just the usual fare of the coppice and the zephron and all the other things. All the troops are armed with javelin, because they're javelin troops, they're light infantry. You've got this awesome shield.
What is that?
I don't know anything.
What's that kind of block?
It's just some bit of copper.
It's just got a ball on the end of it.
Yeah, that's for your hand to fit in. So there's a little handle you can hold it. Oh. So if someone hits it, it breaks your wrist.
Yep.
Yeah. Then we've got the proper, well, almost proper. This is a lighter version of the standard spat. The Hoplon or the Aegis? Apis? What do they call it? The Hoplon shield.
A shield.
Yeah, a shield's Hoplon. Yeah. Then we have the Celtic shield, which was also.
It's popular. Nice to see you too, Ollie.
Hello, Ollie. Are you taking part in the video? Yes, you are. Yes, you are. You're taking part. Right, so we have a number of heads, and the heads could be for any kind of spot, any kind of Greek you want. Most people just do mixed heads, whereas we do them a lot more themed. So let's get on to the figures. These are Thebans. So they have the cheap and nasty shield. No, the expensive shield, not the cheap and nasty shield. So these are Thebans. They've got the Theban helmet on, and they have the plume, and the plume is a nice blue colour because they're Thebans. And that's it. They're just Theban light horse. And they're, because they're light, they're 3 to a base. That's 5 to that. So, what do you think?
Amazing.
Yeah. Overall, useful unit, I suppose. Not really sure. I mean, we haven't really got any experience of playing Greek or Persian to impetus. But we have War of the Roses. And we have discovered that light cavalry are useless in War of the Roses.
I need to use mine.
You need to use yours.
I just heavy cavalry just to beat you.
Yeah, because we didn't find a situation where we could actually use the,
nope,
the silly things.
It moves too fast anyway to use light cavalry, I think.
You know, yeah, it does. It does.
The game's really quick.
Yeah. So that's Greek cavalry. That's it. So there's not a huge amount. They never did anything interesting. They're not famous. They're not like the companions who did awesome things and defeated Persians. I can say one thing, the Macedonians, these are early, so these aren't Macedonians. The Macedonian period, Greek light cavalry had peltasts with them. So it wasn't just the light cavalry, they were mixed in with peltasts infantry. So cavalry didn't mean horses, it meant fast moving units,
yeah,
at the time. But that's not this period. We're doing Archimedean Persian, early Archimedean Persian versus Greeks, whereas later for Macedonian, then these units would be the cavalry with a few infantry mixed in with bows and javelins. And what would happen is the Greeks would then go up, or Greece, yeah, would go and attack, and the cavalry would try and chase off the light Greek cavalry, and the light Greek cavalry would just run away and leave the Greek infantry to pelt the horses, which is very useful. Someone is trying to take part. But we are doing early, not late, and so this is how they come.
Hello there. Hello.
And I've got paint on my hand. Yeah, so that is Persian light cavalry. So what I want to know is, what does little Grumbleface have to say about this?
Nothing now.
You're not talking now. No, you look grumpy. What do you think of Persian light cavalry? Come on, you've been voicing off all this time. What do you think about them?
There you go.
Yeah, so that's it. That's everything got to do with the video. So it is goodbye from me.
And goodbye from him.
And goodbye from the little one. So goodbye.
Bye.